Is this green? Is it gray? Green? As you know, I have tested the Scotch Brite pads by hand with high and average pressure, but someone told me they were interested in their performance with the spinner, so I will be revisiting all of them again, but this time with the spinner. As with the other tests, I'm not going to be using light or moderate pressure. I'm going to be using a little bit more than moderate pressure because these pads don't have a lot of contact area, so the pressure is going to be a bit more than a bit higher than the pressure we use for abalone, true cut, sierra, and all those kind of pads. If you want to know how this pad performs by hand with moderate or high pressure, check the links in the comments below. No, not in the comments, in the description below. Yeah, that one. Now, in case you're not familiar with this pad, this is from 3M. It's the Scotch Brite abrasive pad, and the code it has is 6448. Now, I went to the website of 3M, and they describe this as gray. Although, even in their photo, it looks more green than gray. Now, this pad, this material, is rated at 600 grit, but as I showed in my other video, where I used it by hand, it isn't. But let's see what it can do with the spinner this time. As always, I'm going to start with a very shiny ball. This is around 5500. We're going to verify it, of course. And if you buy a ball and it's factory polished or compound, this is what it's going to look like most of the times. So our result will cover that circumstance. I will scan the ball on two perpendicular planes so we know that the ball is uniformly prepared. And I'm going to spray a little bit of water, just a little bit, because these pads don't need more much water. It's not easy to clog these guys. I'm going to cut the ball on four sides with 15 seconds for each side, so 1 minute for the whole ball, just like the other video. Okay, no video editing from now on. We're beginning the experiment. This is all going to be one cut, as experiments should be. Didn't I tell you? Didn't I tell you? Second scan. Basically. So we're set. Fifteen seconds per side, okay? A little bit of water. last side. Ring popped out. Okay. Jupiter. Over. Looks dusty, it's like almost like it's phased. Let me try to clean it some more on the spinner with a microfiber towel. Okay. Let's see what we got. This ball looks a lot duller than before. But sometimes we can't tell just by looking at it. This guy can tell us. Wow. That's why it looks so dull. That's 1,000. Let's check over here. As before, okay, like here. And on this side we got 1600. Wow. Wow. So I wasn't expecting that. I was expecting a much higher number based on the results we got by hand. But what we got is this. A 5,500 polished ball down to around 1,300, 1,400 over there. Because one side of it was about 1,000 and the other side was about 1,600, so we can average that to around 1300. That's amazing. That's a lot of cut. And these things look like they can take a lot of work and beating. So good to know. So this green pad got us a pretty much a 4,000 worth of cut to our ball as new. I don't know, with each subsequent use this might be lower, but at least as a new pad it gave us a cut of around 4,000 and got our ball down to 1300-1500, and this was rated 600. So okay, it's not what it says because it's not designed for bowling balls, but it can do a pretty good job. As always, if you do a different method, if you do lighter pressure, less duration, more duration, spinner, no spinner, results are gonna vary, okay? And it's gonna vary a lot with these pads. I hope you got some experience points from this video, at least I did. If you like these kinds of experiments and you want to support the channel, there is a link in the description, patreon.com. Or just like, share and subscribe. Thanks, and see you on some other weird test. Bye.